Hi, and welcome to Jim's Radio Shop, and I'm about to change some capacitors on this Philco radio. I think I'm going to be starting with the ones down in here. And we'll take care of these ones down here. So I'm just going to nip them away. These two are definitely parallel. Here we go. Now it could be these were the ones that were leaking earlier tests. So that says 0.01 there. And that looks like it says 0.02 there. Yeah, definitely 0.02. Making this a 0.03. 0.03. 0.03. Now there's another capacitor connected right there. And it could be the guy who's leaking. Where's he connected exactly? Okay, this guy here. Take him off of here. There we go. And we'll pull him out. That's where he goes. And he is a, looks like 0.05. Pretty sure. Okay, so let's go ahead and install these two new capacitors and replace the three old ones. The larger one goes to this wire, and the less large one goes here. That's pretty simple. Thank you. This guy goes here. Good. Okay, let's see, who should we do next? Take this one, swing it out, get at this one down here. Broke right there. I think this is a 0.006. See if that one's good. Yep. Thank you. wax on that wire. .006. have to remember this black one. Leave that there for now. Point one. Black wire. Big connection. Green wire. Remember that. Another big connection. Thank you. 0.05. That was a very deep sigh. That might be all of the paper ones except for this guy here. And these guys look, you know, they should be okay. They look okay. As far as looking can tell. This guy here. Why wouldn't we do it? 0.01. Difference in the size. This won't do it. That was how it was done though. It was down here. So we'll put the new one down there too. Pulled it right off. Pretty bad. It's like I was fighting with it there or something. I wiggled it. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I've shortened the lead way up. Not where I want to be. This resistor will pop off here. That doesn't look too good. Gotta cut that wire. Okay, I think we're ready to try the radio again. Just let me do a little safety check up here. This is the RF signal lead here. Better turn on my RF generator. Signal generator is connected to the antenna lead here. That's just out of sight there. Volume is down. Safety is good. Go ahead. Not plugged in. Ready? Go. It must be turned off. There we are. Still quiet in the top end here. And give it full voltage. Not sure why that's going dead up there. Terrible reception. Okay, let's use the signal generator now. I'll put this about mid. There, about mid band there. This is pretty close. There it is there. Well, I dare say that's better. Dare. Turn on my audio signal too. Just give it a moment. We'll have to do the IF again. Well, we'll check it. We'll check it and see. There we are. A little bit of trouble with my signal generator. Well, that's lovely. Very good. Certainly works. I'm going to really have to do something about the antenna in my shop here. Give these radios a better chance to actually receive something. But let's do an alignment on this guy. And I think I'm just going to feed the IF right into the antenna. We'll see how that goes. Okay, so we're gonna dial up to 455. See if we hear it. Okay. Yes, I'm using a metal screwdriver to do this. Pad cap. There was really barely any movement in those screws, so the changing of the capacitors didn't have any effect on the tuning of the IF, nothing appreciable. So I think we've got ourselves a radio here.